What's up, guys? If you haven't already gotten the hint of this project from the past videos I've posted, this is my permanent holiday LED light setup. These are going to stay up on the house 24/7, and I will use these as my holiday lights for Halloween, Valentine's Day, Christmas, Thanksgiving, any sports games. And I'm going to show you the features of my setup. This bottom floor and garage triangle, that consists of 524 LEDs, about 88 feet of permatrack. And then the top is about 36 feet with 192 LEDs. In the beginning, I wanted to have my whole setup run off of one dig quad, but I couldn't get data to the top portion of it. I was getting some issues with the length of the cable, so I had to put a little ammo box up there with a Diguno in it. This is my dig quad setup. You can see I got my power supply to the right, my quad to the left. I used both of the power terminals for the quad. I didn't want any voltage drop. Ultimately, I will have my whole sequence run off of this quad as soon as the rest of my parts come in stock. You could see the third terminal on the power supply. That cable is actually the cable that I was going to use to power the second floor LEDs, but I ran into that data issue. So instead of putting another power supply outside, I just rigged that cable to the power supply and ran it to the Diguno, and that powers that on. Also, having it on one power supply keeps everything streamlined, keeps everything mainstream. I only have to worry about one area of power, not having to worry about two power supplies and two different smart plugs and two different setups. Everything gets powered on by this power supply, and then I can configure everything from one point. But let's go ahead and go over the WLED settings. So we're opening WLED. We see both dig quad and dig uno. The top one is the quad, the bottom is the uno. Let's go into the quad. And one cool thing is we have this button sync, and sync will control all the other digs on the network. So we have two independent digs. I'm going to choose an effect and they both should change at the same time. So let's do bouncing balls. And let's change the color to blue. We could do green. And then we could do red. Cool. And these lights are RGB lights. So the white is a bluish white, not a yellowish white. They do have other LED pixel strings out there that have a dedicated white channel. But I didn't want to go too far or spend too much in the beginning. But those ones with the dedicated white channel, and I think they only come in strips. So I really wanted to do the strings with the individual pixels. Let's try another effect. One of my other effects that I was using for Halloween was this Halloween with the purple and orange chase. Another cool effect that I like is the fireworks series. This is the fireworks. And on some of the effects, my quad is hooked up to the network via Ethernet, and my Uno is on wireless. So you could see there's a little bit of a delay. Let's see if I change the effect. Yeah, I changed the effect and it did probably a sync or send out another signal. I'll let the cars go by. And a cool colorful one is Fireworks Starburst. And one I'm gonna use for Christmas is the candy cane one. So this is a nice candy cane. and my bottom row, those pixels are all facing down, and the track that I got for the triangles for the garage and the second floor are all side. So the way they go is they connect to the house and then they point down, and the ones that are on the first floor, those are bottom. So I wanted all of the pixels to be facing down. Then we could do a chase, and this is a chase we could have with three, and I think we can choose three different colors. Could do white and then do like a red, white, and blue. But you see, when we added changes like this, the sync really didn't come out as well. We could always have it run off of a quad and have different segments so they could run two different effects, but for this it'll be kind of tedious to go back and forth. Let's see if they turn the car alarm off. Okay, we changed the effect, and the top section is not changing. And that's why I want to run everything off of one unit. Now I changed the effect, it's synced back up. So it's not too bad. We could probably go back and forth with certain effects, and maybe it sends out another signal. We have a lot of cool rainbow ones. This is a nice rainbow. Here's another rainbow. This one is cool too. We could do a strobe and strobe mega. This is a nice theater function. Let's go back and turn off the colors. Probably put it to white or turn that off. Yeah, so now that looks more like a theater. Like the old school, but those lights were a little like incandescent. So let's try to get some yellow in there. Yeah, so you won't get that warm of a white. You'll get more of a cool white. This popcorn one's cool too. Then this one's a comet. I guess comets go slow. This one's a meteor. I guess meteors are faster. And that one's a cool effect. We have another color in there, so it's sort of like twinkles. This is another meteor. So it goes from one color to the other color. Then we have a lighthouse. So it looks like the top level is stuck on the other effect. And let's change the effect and let's see if that syncs. But yeah, there you go. This is my project. I hope you guys like it. This is something I've been working on for the past year. Just getting all the hardware together. getting the weather to cooperate. Most of my parts came in the dead of winter in the beginning of the year, and I just didn't want to work outside in those kinds of conditions. And just so you guys don't think I'm crazy, my neighborhood does celebrate a lot of holidays, so they do have holiday lights on right now. This is mid-November and we have houses on with their holiday light shows.